The team news, please. Injury latest.
No bad news, and this is important. And we have all the players available, and it's okay. Apart Romero and Giovanni Lo Celso, and for Romero, as I said to you before, he needs a long time before to recover. Instead, Giovanni, I think after the game against Norwich, he will be ready to start again the training session with us.
The fight for fourth position seems very open now. Tottenham could be in the fourth position by the end of these fixtures. We know you want to do a lot of work, and a lot of work needs to be done. If you finished fourth, would this be one of the best, biggest achievements of your managerial career?
I think that in this moment it's more important to go game by game, and I think it's very important to look ourselves, not the other, and surely the table is very important, and I always said that we want to try to stay close at the first positions, because when you stay close, and then you can improve with the work. We can improve with the time to improve many aspects. No, with the players, and then we'll see what happens. And surely we need to improve, to be very good. And also to hope that other teams can sleep, but at the same time we have to stay there. We have to stay very close. There is only one way to do this, to get 3 points. And against Norwich, we have another important game, difficult game, but it will be very important to get 3 points. The players know very well that we have to try to exploit this moment, every situation, to continue to have a good momentum, and to stay there, to make points is important. The table is important, and the win give us confidence and trust in the work, trust in the idea, and for us it's very important to exploit this situation.
That's fine. Ian Abrahams, please.
Hiya, you're right. Unbeaten in the Premier League, good win last night, but the only thing missing is Harry Kane scoring in the Premier League at home and really getting going in terms of scoring regularly in the Premier League. So how much are you hoping Sunday he'll score, and that is the lack of goals from him a worry for you?
First of all, I'm sure that Harry is happy if we win, he doesn't score. And because Tottenham is the first thought for us. And Harry, and as I said yesterday, played a really good game. He was in the situation that we scored, and he had also a good chance to score. But it's important, I think, to have chance to score. And we are improving a lot under this aspect. I'm sure that Harry is going to score many goals. But for sure, I'm sure that he's going to have a good performance in the same way that he had against Brentford, but against every team that we played. I'm very pleased for the way that he's playing, and then I know that the striker wants to score. We want to give him many chances to score, and I think we are in the right path to have this type of situation.
Okay, we'll go to Lindsay Hooper on Zoom, please.
Following on from that, Antonio, I just wondered how you explain Harry Kane's goal-scoring form for England compared to club. Have you managed to get your head around that?
I think that Premier League is a very, very tough league. And every game that you go to play is not easy. And I think that sometimes during the with the national team, you can play against team not so strong, and also to have more opportunity to score, not only for him, but for all the players. This league is very strong. This league is the most difficult league in the world, and for this reason, it's not simple for to win a game, to get 3 points, to score goals. And this is the great difference that you can find between the two different situations.
Thanks, Lindsay. Staying on Zoom, we'll go to Sung Mo Lee, please.
Hi, Antonio. Hey. Son has scored yesterday and also contributed your first goal as well. And at last press conference, you said you think Son is better at number 10 or at his own position at the moment. So can you tell me about what did you mean about number 10? Is it, did you mean attacking midfielder or a second top or free role midfielder, or what's your view or plan for Son, please?
Yeah, but for me, and with this system we are playing with two number 10, and but for me they are two strikers, and we are playing with a number 9 that is Kane as a point of reference, and then two players very offensively Sonny and Lucas. In the start 11, because behind we have Bergwijn and then also Dele Alli, Giovanni Lo Celso, and Brian Hill. For me, Sonny is a really, really good player. He's a top player, and he's a modern player, and he's a good. He has great quality. At the same time, he's fast, he has a resilience, and he's strong. When you have all of these characteristics, it means that you are a top player. And Sonny has all of these characteristics.
Thanks, Sungmo. Back in the room, we'll go Alistair Gold, please.
Hey, Antonio. I just wanted to ask you about Joe Roden. He's been here over a year now. He hasn't had many starts in the Premier League. Just wondering whether Christian Romero's injury might give him more opportunities under you.
Yeah, the first thing that I'm trying to do and I'm doing and to find the right position for every single player and to try to, in every position, to have a double player. And for the characteristic, in my idea, I see Joe behind Eric Dier in the central position. And for sure, this position is a singular position. Not if you are central defender on the right, on the left, and you can have more options to play, to stay behind the central defenders and... you have only one option. But Joe is a player that showed me a really, really great commitment and a will, a desire to learn, to improve himself. And I think that this is good. This is good. This is a really good example for also for the other players. And he's a silent player. That work because he knows that he wants to improve, and I'm satisfied for the improvement that I'm seeing during the training session. How about him?
And last one in this section, Jonathan Veal, please.
Thanks. Hugo Lloris is out of contract in the summer. Have you spoken to him about his future? Do you think he'll sign a new contract? And would you like to see him stay at the club?
I have just arrived and only 1 month. And in this moment, for sure, we have all many situations to solve. And Hugo is a captain of this team. He's the captain of French. We are talking about a top world goalkeeper. And he's very focused now, and he knows very well that now we have to try to do our best. Me as a coach, Hugo as goalkeeper, and every player has to perform at high level. But for sure, and we'll have the time to speak about him. And I consider him an important player for Tottenham, for his experience, for because he's a good goalkeeper, first of all. And then many years with this club, and he shows always a great commitment, no, for this club.
Thanks, Jonathan. Okay. Well-